In this video, I want to show you how our knowledge of the divergence theorem and Stokes theorem can be used to convert the what's called the integral form of Maxwell's equations into their differential form. So we have four of Maxwell's equations in integral form. We have Gauss's law, which tells you that the surface integral of the electric field is equal to the charge enclosed. We have these two constants, epsilon naught is the permittivity of free space, and then mu naught is the permeability of free space. These show up in the SI unit system that engineers typically use. So we have Gauss's law. Then we have Gauss's law for magnetic fields, which is the same as Gauss's law for electric field, except the right-hand side is zero, and we say that law states that there are no magnetic monopoles. Then Faraday's law, the integral of the electric field around a closed curve is, so if you have a closed curve, and then you have a magnet that you move in and out of this wire, this circular wire, then you have a time-varying change in the B, you end up with an electric field. So actually it causes a current to flow in the wire. That's Faraday's law. So Faraday's law was important because it was the first time someone showed a connection between the electric field and the magnetic field. Then we have Ampere Maxwell's law, which gives you the integral of the magnetic field around a closed curve is equal to this constant mu naught times the current that the closed curve, that passes through the closed curve. That's Ampere's form of the law. And then Maxwell added this very important second term that was then enabled the Maxwell's equations to predict the electromagnetic waves. Okay, so how do we convert these integral form of Maxwell's equations to differential form? Well, we need to replace the charge and the current by the charge density and the current density. And the formula is that this charge, or the charge enclosed, is going to be equal to the integral over the volume of the charge density times dV. And the same for the current. The current enclosed by this loop is going to be equal to a surface integral of the current density dotted into dS, the surface element. Okay? With those definitions of a charge density and a current density, then we can manipulate the Maxwell's equation. So let's start with Gauss's law. So we have Q now is rho dV, so it's an integral over a volume. So we can use the divergence theorem to convert the closed surface integral into a volume integral. So Gauss's law can become an integral over a volume. And then we have del dot E from the divergence theorem. And then we can bring the right-hand side to the left. So we have a minus rho over epsilon, epsilon naught. And then integrating then dV. And that's supposed to be equal to zero, okay? So application of the divergence theorem, replacing the charge by the charge density, gives us this integral equation. But this is true for any volume, okay? So if it's true for any volume, the integrand has to be identically zero. And that's the Gauss's law in differential form. So we get del dot E equals rho over epsilon naught. Okay? So that is the first of Maxwell's equations in differential form. We can do the same thing for Gauss's law for magnetic fields. Here we just apply, this just becomes del dot B dV equals zero. So immediately you can see that del dot B then has to be zero. And that would be Gauss's law for magnetic fields, which basically says there's no such thing as a magnetic monopole. Okay, how about Faraday's law? Here we have a integral over a closed curve, so we can apply Stokes' theorem and convert that to del cross E dot ds. So we have then the integral over a surface. We have a del cross E applying Stokes' theorem. And then the d dt we can bring inside of the integral sign. B is a function of position and time, so d dt on the outside, because we're integrating over the position variable here, when you bring it in, it becomes a partial derivative. We bring it to the left-hand side, it becomes plus partial of B with respect to t. And then this whole thing then is then dotted into ds and is equal to zero. Okay? So again, this is true for any surface enclosing any surface. And so if it's true for any surface, the integrand has to be zero. So we get the differential form of Faraday's law then would be del cross E equals negative dB dt. And that's the third of Maxwell's equations. Okay, now what about the Ampere-Maxwell's law? Well, it's the same idea then. We convert B dot dr into del cross B dot ds. So we have the integral over a surface. We have del cross B. And then we bring the right-hand side to the left. The I enclosed then becomes, we want to change I enclosed into this integral over the surface of J dot ds. So we have a minus mu naught. And then we have a J, right? And then we have a plus epsilon naught. We have this surface integral here. So again, we bring the d dt inside of the integral. So it becomes partial E with respect to t. Okay, this whole thing multiplied by mu naught. And then this whole thing, then this is a vector, gets dotted into ds. And that's supposed to be zero. Okay? So it's almost the same as Faraday's law, except we have one extra term, which is the which is the current here, and then we replace that with the current density. So again, this is zero for any surface, and then we can write down the fourth Maxwell's equations, which will be del cross B then is equal to mu naught times J plus epsilon naught dE dt. And that's the differential form of the Ampere-Maxwell's equations. Okay, let me put a nice check here. So we got four Maxwell's equations. Okay, so let me summarize. The purpose of this video is to show you the power, the theoretical power of the divergence theorem and Stokes theorem. So in a beginning electricity and magnetism course, typically you learn Maxwell's equations in their integral form. And then when you move to an intermediate electricity and magnetism course, you finally learn them in their differential form. Because in order to get from kind of the experimentally accessible integral form to the differential form, you need to know some vector calculus. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching.